Hi, everybody. Welcome to Disastrously Domestic. How the hell are ya? It has been a really, 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 really long time. January happened, and our family caught every plague to hit the PNW. So, yes, it was a lot of fun. A lot of gross, lingering, ill fun. But I feel better now. Hallelujah. Okay, so there's that. My name is Jessica, and I try to do this podcast weekly or semi-weekly. And I feel like I have a whole slew of crap to talk about this week because of my absence, but that's all right. That's fine. Y'all will sit there and listen to it, or you won't. So, if you would like to follow me on Instagram, you can find me there as disastrously_domestic. And if you'd like to find me on Ravelry, I am Sugar Sticks over there. I think that's about it. I'm drinking tea today in my amazing male tears cup. Eat your hearts out. This is red raspberry leaf tea. I believe it was called Mighty Aphrodite from David's Tea. And shit, it's hot. Oh my god. Way too hot to drink right now. It's very good though. Try it. It is not caffeinated. So I guess I'm gonna stop rambling and just get into FOs because I have a lot. And I'm wearing one! So, I've been showing this for a few episodes now. And this is my blanket. It is the Pengu-oh-no sweater, and it is done, and it is huge, and it is glorious. And I don't know how to show it properly. But, look at my butt. Okay. No, this isn't gonna work. It's not gonna work. There's really just no way. But I can do what I've done up until this point in showing it and just hold it up. So, sleeve. It's got stripes up the side. This welty bit there, which is pretty cool. Most of this yarn is hand-spun. The neutrally colors are not hand-spun, but the fun stuff is all hand-spun. So show the front. Ooh, that's the first side. And the second side. And this thing you're supposed to be able to wear the way that I was wearing it, which you saw, and also turn it upside down so that it has like these long like fronts that kind of dangle. I really don't know how to wear this thing. It's my blanket. It's not a sweater that I'm ever going to wear anywhere. This is the Pengu-oh-no sweater by Stephen West. I don't know if I said that. And I did, you can make the sweater smaller by using skinnier yarn and smaller needles, but I did bulky on size 11s, so that is why it is huge. It is a clown sweater. I love clowns, so that's okay. The creepier, the better. Okay, so I love this, and I want to make another one, but I want to make it with smaller yarn so that maybe, just maybe, I'll be able to wear this monstrosity out of the house. But I'm gonna put it back on until I get too hot to wear it. Because I love it. So that's my first FO. It's a big one. It's huge. It really, in terms of time, time spent knitting, was not that big of a project, but it felt like it took me forever. And it's a sweater. Well, it's a blanket. This is the biggest sweater I've ever knit. So what's next? I also finished my husband's scarf that I call the Negan scarf. It's the Trillian Shawl by Martina Bem. And he was supposed to leave it home today so that I could show it. And he failed to do so because he wears it. He's pretty much worn it like every time, like every day. So that's nice that he likes it, but kind of crappy that he forgot to leave it for me to show you guys. So, and I really like it, and I'm so happy that he likes it. So, yay. The other thing that I am gonna show is also for my husband, and it is something that was finished like for the last two episodes, but I just never showed you guys. But I finally found them. They're dirty and gross and have like dog hair all over them and are not blocked. And socks! My husband's socks. So there's the cable. I'm not gonna like go too in depth because I've talked about these before. I just wanted to show them finally. Finally finished. Make it official on the podcast. He does wear these too, so that's a good thing. What else? What else? I have a lot of FOs. I have three more, I think. Okay, so we did the Women's March on Washington, Seattle March. We did not go to Washington, but we did attend that march, and I knit hats for me, my husband, and my son. And this is the one that I made for my husband. I don't know what yarn it is. It was like some European brand. Super, super bulky. But I got this amazing button from Katrinkles. She has an Etsy shop, and I thought this was a very appropriate button for a protest march hat. And also a very appropriate button for my husband. He feels this sentiment. He does. He's a good man. That's that. He wore it. But then the one I made for Warren is this one. And I put little ear flaps on it. And a little eye cord. And he wore this one. And it just looked so cute. And he wore it for just the march. He would not wear it on the train or on the bus to get there. And he would not wear it after we left the march. He only would wear it at the march. Because, as I have mentioned before, my boy is a very serious boy. Very serious indeed. So, that. I'm sorry, I have more than that, actually. So, I finished a pair of socks for myself. These are the Rye Socks by Tin Can Knits. And I knit these in Tosh DK Cathedral colorway. That's the gist. They're shorty socks. Cozy and warm. And they're going in the box of socks for 2017, because yes, I am gonna try that again. Will I succeed? Perhaps. Perhaps I will, because you know what? I didn't start my box of socks last year at the beginning of the year. I started it like midpoint through the year. So, I'm hoping, starting it at the beginning of the year, everything's gonna be fine. It's gonna be fine. I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna get it done. Next FO. These are a pair of soakers for unborn spawn. These are the Spare Ribs Shoker. S-H-O-A-K-E-R. I don't know why they spelled it that way instead of soaker, but whatever. This is a pattern that I actually knit for Warren when he was a baby and liked it, so I knit another one. And this is knit in Noro Cleopatra. And yeah, I mean, Noro is Noro and does what Noro does. I just love these. I can't wait. These have not been lanolized yet. But they will be. So this is the first thing that I have completed for the baby. And I'm excited about it. So excited about it. I'm gonna say excited a lot. I always do. And finally, I have one more FO that I want to show. And it is a very cool cowl designed by Riza Knits. Cassandra. She has a podcast that I think she has started updating again. But this is the Equinox cowl. And there's also a scarf version, but basically it's sparse trees on a background, and you stitch it up. Let's go all the way around. So it's very cool. I love it. Equinox Cowl by Riza Knits. It's awesome. This is Knit in Tosh DK. Yay! And I think that is all for my FOs. It's a lot. It really is, for me. I usually don't have any FOs. I'm a bad knitter. Yeah. So I guess we can just move on to whips. And I have a list. I'm looking. That's why I'm, you know, doing this business. But I'm not going to show everything here because I don't feel like digging all this crap out. But I will show the things that I have readily available around me right now. And the first of which is in my tote bag. It has the really fun map of the Snoqualmie Valley. And in here I have two projects. The first is being knit in Lolo Did It Lucille on her cashmere base. I believe it's Lolo's Favorite is the name of this base. And I'm knitting the Across the Pond shawl by Mina Phillip of the Knitting Expat podcast. Last time I showed it, here's my marker. Can you see it? It's black, so it's kind of hard to see. And I have added quite a bit to it. Let's put it up onto the needles so that you can see a better size representation, although I don't want to lose any stitches. Yes. Doo-doo-doo. There it is. It's pretty. I like this yarn a lot. And I need to find a color for the border. And I think I'm going to go with another Lolo Did It yarn. The color is called Sriracha. And it's very similar to this deep red color for the border. But yes, this is fun. Easy to memorize pattern. And cashmere, you know, I mean, come on. Who's gonna complain about working with cashmere? Not Jessica. Other project that I have in this same bag is actually a hoe. I finished a sock. This is the Arrow sock by Cookie A. And I used a super variegated yarn, so you can't really see the arrow aspect of the sock. But maybe, see, it has little arrows everywhere. I finished the first sock, and I started the second one. I have done the heel flap and gusset, and I'm now just working my way down the toe. hopefully I'll be done with these sometime this week. And I'll have another pair of socks for my box of socks. I like this pattern a lot, and I'm kind of bummed that I chose this yarn, even though I do love this yarn. This is yarn that I dyed myself. It's a BFL with this really fluorescent yellow, which is not coming out as bright on the camera as it is in real life. It's very, like, eye-searing yellow and pink. But I was thinking I might knit these again in a yarn that is less variegated so that you could see the arrows, because I'm kind of a fan of arrows because of my last name. Although I like up-down arrows. I don't... Yeah, so the reason... My last name is pronounced Hilo, so Hi-Lo, and when I tell people how to pronounce it, I'm usually like, Hi-Lo. And so I like up-down arrows, okay? Because I can connect it to my name. These are just downward-pointing arrows, but still, I was like, ah! I'm weird. I'm weird. Anyway, these are fun. Fun, springy colors, which is why I pulled these out, because I started these last year. I know last year was not that long ago, but, you know. Let's face it, things take me a long time, and I'm aware of it. Yes! Okay, so I don't know if I ever mentioned this on the podcast, but I had told myself that I had to wait to buy yarn for this project that I'm about to show you until after I finished my Pengu-oh-no sweater. And the day I bound off, I bought this kit from We Are Knitters. And they come in these giant bags. This is the Zermatt cardigan. It is knit on size 19 needles. You guys. These are huge. Monstrous needles. And I am so excited about this project. It's just this oversized seed stitch cardigan. And it's basically the shape of it is the kind of thing that I buy in store-bought sweaters. Like, ridiculously oversized, long, frumpy sweaters are kind of my jam when it comes to store-bought sweaters. And so I decided I would love to make one for myself, but knowing how long it would take to knit something like that, I wanted a bulky one. And so I discovered these kits, and this is my yarn. It's just a wool singles. And it's in this really beautiful corally pink color. Oh my god, guys. I want to eat it. I want to eat it. Get in my belly. So, progress. Quite a bit, actually. I finished the back piece of it. And it's basically just a giant... It's been folded. Just a giant rectangle. And my fabric is looking like this. Ugh, so luscious. I love it. It's super soft. It will pill. I know. I just know it will. It's very fuzzy. It's a singles. It's bulky. And it's not knit at a super tight gauge. It's very stretchy and... All these things add up to this MF a gonna pill, but I don't care because I could look like a vagrant with a pilly sweater. That is totally fine with me. I accept this, my lot in life. So that's the back, and then I started the front pieces. I'm doing them concurrently. Because I can. It does mean that they are very squished up on the needles, though, so that they don't fall off, but Yeah, so I've got my front pieces going. And this has taken, like, no time at all. And that is super satisfying to me because I am not known for my patience. Jezebel's not a patient girl. Nope. But I do like pretty things, and I do like knitting. I guess I'm more of a process knitter than a product knitter. I think I've accepted that about myself. Even though I really like having things, like the thing, I think that the amount of projects that I cast on, I just don't have a lot of finished things. Because I just get excited. Ooh, look at this! I want to do this! And yeah, so let's take a break. Let's take a little break. I leave my tea in my cup, and usually I leave my spoon in my cup too, like throughout the entire drinking process. And my husband makes fun of me because sometimes I poke myself in the face or the eye with my spoon. But I like this one because this little steeper, because I can kind of pretend it's a spoon, and then my tea can get like even stronger as I drink it. I don't know why that satisfies me so much. It just does. Okay, next whip. As you all know, last time I was not sure if I was going to be sticking with the Find Your Fade shawl, and ultimately I decided not to. I frogged it and was looking for another thing to knit, and came across the Brickless pattern by Martina Behm, who also did the Trillian shawl that I was showing earlier. And I decided to use my fade colors for this shawl instead. So it starts with Neon Peach by Madeline Tosh. This is Tosh Merino Light. So what's cool about this pattern is it's kind of patchworky, so it's got this lace section followed by a little garter section followed by a rib section. And I did two repeats. But as you work on it, you bind off along this lower edge a few stitches to get this like sawtooth look. And the number of stitches you bind off differ for each section. So like this is a longer tooth than this little guy. It just makes a really cool texture. So this color is Tiger Lily by Mrs. Crosby Likes to Play. This is the satchel base. And then this is Marte colorway by Malabrigo. And oh my gosh, I love this color so much. So those are the three colors that I had for my fade, and I was going to... My initial plan for the fade was to buy more colors as I needed them. And I'm debating if I'm gonna still do that. Because the plan with the fade was to start at this really bright pink, corally pink, and then go into almost black. Which would also look really cool in this pattern. Although this has more, it's less of a fade, it's more of a just sudden change. But I like it because it's a different texture, so it makes sense to change colors. You don't have to think about it too much. I don't know. But it's pretty long from tip to tip. Alrighty, so I don't know. It doesn't take a lot of yarn to knit a section, even with it increasing, so I'm just debating if it's worthwhile to buy a few more skeins of yarn to make this my fade, you know. But I do love it a lot, but I'm at a stopping point. The other thing I could do is I could come back to this and just repeat this sequence again, which I might do. I don't know. Decisions, decisions. But this is on hold until I can make up my mind. I don't know how long that'll be, because I've been spending a lot of money. So it's kind of irresponsible to keep doing that. I don't know. So it's a hard decision. What should I do? I don't know. What should I do? I think it would be really cool to have it go into a really dark, charcoal-y, burnt-up gray color. But it might not happen. I don't know. I don't know. I never know until it happens. So I never know. Next project. Yay! I have been working on my February lady sweater, and I have it here. This is Cascade 220 that I dyed with black currant. Where's my stitch marker? There's my stitch marker from last time I showed you guys. So I added a couple inches to it. And yeah, I don't know what else to say. I added a couple inches. I apparently stopped in the middle of a row. But there it is. I was gonna do around 8 buttonholes, and I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 buttonholes. I'm a few rows away from buttonhole number 7. And yeah, it's cute. And it smells amazing because I have in my bag, I have this really fun Douglas fir filled pouch that says Ballard on it, which is the neighborhood I live in Seattle, in case you're curious. It smells so good. And I got this at Christmas time, and I should have bought like 10 of them to put in all my bags, because I want everything to smell like this. Love it. I should have been born a woodland creature, let's just say. But I wasn't. I'm a human. More whips. Let's keep going, shall we? Let's just keep this crazy train going. I have 2 pairs of socks that I started. One of which I might have shown in the past, but I don't know. It is the watermelon yarn from the Yarn Enabler. It comes as a kit like this. And I am knitting the Mercury socks. So you can see you start with the green, you go into the white, and then you go into your pink with the black for the seeds. And I am so in love with this. Oh my gosh. I love watermelon. Warren loves watermelon. It's like his favorite fruit. My mom will die if she eats watermelon. True story. She is deathly allergic to melons. My childhood was very devoid of melons, except when I went to my grandparents' house and then they stuffed me. but yeah, there's the pattern. You can see it a lot better than I thought you could, actually. That excites me. I was a little worried as I was knitting it, but I kind of also didn't care because I just wanted to knit the Mercury socks that everyone else is knitting because joiner. Yes. One thing I'm doing a little differently that I thought I might mention, I'm doing a heel flap and gusset. It's a eye of partridge, which I love. Heel flap and gusset, what I'm doing differently here, I noticed that I'm often pretty tight on the instep. My feet are not wide or big. I'm a size 7 US, which is average woman size. But I do notice that some of my hand knits get a little tight on the instep. And I also have like chicken legs, so I'm not going to cast on more stitches because then they just sag and bag in the leg. So I thought maybe it would help for the gusset, instead of decreasing every other round, which is what you typically do with a gusset, I'm doing every third round, so that there are more stitches for longer, if that makes sense. To me, it makes sense, and I'm trying it out, especially on this, because the stitch count that you cast on is a little less than what I typically do. I typically do 64, and this, I want to say is like 60 or so. I don't know. I don't remember how many, but it's less than what I usually do, and so I was like extra concerned about that instep area, really just right here. Once it's on the top, like on the top part of my foot, it's fine. It's just where I hinge, I guess, that I feel like I need a little extra space. But these are super fun. I love them. And it almost makes me want summer to get here. But I am not a summer girl. I am pale and pasty forever. By choice. Sunblock is my friend, even in the winter time. I don't really want summer to come, but I do at the same time. I don't know. Other sock is being knit out of this yarn. This is a mini from Etsy somewhere. And this is, I don't remember the name of this colorway, but it is by Francophie Knits. This is one of her Christmas colorways. You can no longer get it. Sorry. But when I saw it, it's supposed to be like peppermint bark colors. But when I saw this, I thought, peppermint butler. Okay? And so I got this. And I started making a pair of socks inspired by my favorite Adventure Time character, Master of the Dark Arts, Peppermint Butler. I'm using carbons. Here's what I got. I am not using a pattern. I did a long cuff in the blue, and I am just doing a very simple slip stitch pattern to kind of give a pinstripe look. I'm slipping the stitches for 4 rounds and then knitting them on the 5th round. So it's a very exaggerated slip stitch. And I love it. I think it looks so cool, especially, I feel like this is Peppermint Butler. I feel like I captured it. I do. I really do. I love that show so much. Did you guys see Haverland Yarns? I follow her on Instagram. She has just tested out an Adventure Time inspired self-striping colorway. And I am like, OMG, I need that. Bad. Because I feel like she nailed it. I've seen a lot of Adventure Time colors, and I don't feel like people nailed it as well as she nailed it. So she needs to make that happen. And I need to get in on that, because it'll probably sell out before I could get it. But whatever, that's my life. I'll try. Socks. one more one more project that I'm going to show, okay? And this, I'm really proud of myself for working on, because this is a project that I started quite a few years ago, and I pulled it out and was like, this is ridiculous. Let me actually, I'm going to pull up my project page, because I want to know, I want to be able to tell you guys when I started these. Some Cloudy Day by Tiny Owl Knits. These are leg warmers that are very, very tall. I added these to Ravelry in 2013. So I pulled them out and started working on them. I will show you, I have one finished already. Looks like this. Has this cute kind of butterfly looking pattern on there. Can you see it? This is a Lorna's Laces colorway that was from their like warehouse sale. It's not an actual colorway of theirs. Like it was like a mistake skein kind of thing. It's a sport weight. So this one was finished and has been finished since like 2013 or 2012 or whatever. And I had started, so this is how much I had on number two. Not a whole lot. And so I moved, I decided that I just needed to finish these because it's on size 4 needles, it's sport weight yarn, it's really not gonna take that long. And it's just ridiculous that I have not finished these. So, someday. hopefully soon. So again, these are Some Cloudy Day by Tiny Owl Knits. And that is being housed in this amazing new bag that I got yesterday in the mail. This is from Erica Schmerica Designs. There's her little tag. Look at that. That's Jason Voorhees. Yes, it is. Cold-blooded killer right there. Camp Crystal Lake. Oh my god. This makes my horror fan girl heart so happy. I love this. And look. Even better. Holy crap. Am I right? Am I right? I'm right. I actually found this fabric on Spoonflower, and I'm thinking about ordering it in not like a quilt cotton, but like a apparel fabric to make myself a sweater. Not a sweater, like a shirt. Or something. Or a tie for my husband. Something. Because this is amazing fabric. I love it. So yeah, I think, no, I have one more thing to show. I started a baby blanket. This is the Pinwheel Scrap Blanket by Mina Philip. And this is what I have so far. This here and this were in the cowl that I showed earlier, the Equinox cowl. So yeah, this is from my Rye socks that I showed earlier as well. And then the green and blue I had purchased to add into this. Okay, so I'm back. I'm wearing a completely different outfit. And yeah, my camera ran out of space completely. And I just was so frustrated, I decided, screw it, I'm done for the day, and I will pick this back up tomorrow, which is what I did. And it is now today. So I think the last thing that I was talking about was the blanket that I cast on for the baby. This one. I will show you. And I think I talked a little bit about it. think I mentioned all these yarns, and I had bought this one fresh. I bought this one fresh, and the rest are leftovers from other projects. And then this was actually Edison bulb is going to be added to it here at some point. These are all Tosh GK, so I had Edison bulb in my stash already. So that one was not purchased. But I did buy one more color of the Tosh DK, called Stormborn, but that has not arrived yet. So, but those are my colors. And yes, this seems to be a very expensive baby blanket with the amount of Tosh colorways that are present, but again, stash, or leftover, scrap. And then I'm hoping with the other colors that I will make other items, that it just won't all be for a blanket. So I'm hoping to make some stripey cardigans and things like that, either for the baby or put it in something for Warren. Yeah, so that's how I'm justifying this baby blanket costing, you know. Well, you can do that math if you're interested. So yeah, that is in this project bag by Belly of a Whale. And it is jam-packed in here. It is not going to fit for very much longer. So yes, that is my last whip for knitting. And I mentioned this in the beginning in the FO section. This is the Negan-inspired Trillian shawl that I knit for my husband. Since it's the next day, I made sure that he left it. And I figured I might as well just show it to you guys. So this is what it looks like on. Can you see the whole thing? Maybe. And of course he's been wearing it and it hasn't been, it's starting to like curl. The edging of it is starting to like curl back up again because it's been, yeah. But here it is. End to end, just solid red. Well, slightly tonal red, I guess. And yeah, he really likes it. And it's really soft. One of the things that I was concerned about with this yarn was that it's a Targi yarn, which I've never used, and it felt a little rough while I was working with it. And I wasn't sure if it would soften up a lot or not. But it seems to be very, very soft, and he has not complained, so. And he is a delicate flower, I will say. My husband is a delicate flower. He has eczema issues and sensitive skin issues, so him saying it's not bothering him does in fact mean something. But yeah, so there's that. So now that I've shown all my FOs, I think, I hope, I can move on to sewing. Because I have quite a bit to talk about in terms of sewing projects. I made my son a love monster for Valentine's Day. And he looks like this. He's got stripy legs and stripy arms. I did this little half square triangle thing with like red, white, and blue colored fabrics, and he's got a little tongue with scrap jersey, a little heart eye with a giant wooden button, and then this other eye. Look how cool that button is. It has 9 holes, and I thought that'd be a perfect eyeball. And then this is like a, you can see it better on the back, a very, very plush, soft material. So he has a zipper pocket. It's all fully lined, like, amazingly. Like, I'm really proud of this. I didn't use a pattern. I just kind of had something in mind and made it happen. So you can tuck his tongue in and zip him up if you want. But yes, I think I love it more than my son loves it, but that's okay. I can hug him, he's so cute. Yes, so I did some sewing. Woot! Also for my son, had this project planned for a really long time and started for a really long time, and it is a t-shirt quilt with all of Warren's Too Small Now t-shirts. And the reason that I ultimately pulled this project back out was because I was watching Bad Wolf Girl Sits and Knits podcast with Meg. And she had shown some t-shirt quilts that she had made from marathon t-shirts, I guess, that she had done with her husband, and it was like a memory, nice memory kind of quilt thing. And I was like, oh, I have something like that started. And I had everything washed, I had everything cut, and all I had to do was just sew it all together. And I did. So I'm not gonna be able to show this on screen, but I can just kind of hold it up a little bit, show you just a quick glimpse. These are all Warren's little baby and toddler shirts. There's also a picture on Instagram. But this is not finished. It's just the quilt top, which I kind of consider quilt tops to be, yeah, I don't know if you even saw that, but I consider quilt tops to be FOs in and of themselves, even though it's not really an FO. Just cause like, they're so satisfying. And it usually takes me a really long time to get around to making, to actually finishing quilts. I think I've finished one quilt. No, two or three quilts in my life, but I've finished quite a few quilt tops. Whoops. But I do hope to finish that. I'd like to finish that before baby gets here. You know, because. What else? I have some fabric to show future project plans in terms of sewing, but I have one more thing that I started that's living in this cute little tin from IKEA. I caught the hexagon English paper piecing bug, and I started myself a little kit for 1-inch hexagons. I have 3 fabrics already hexied up, if that makes sense. First I'll show. Okay, so I got these little printout things from, Wild Olive, and I think it's blogspot.com. So each side here is 1 inch, and you cut these out and you fold your paper, or you fold your fabric around and stitch it together, and then you hand sew all your little pieces together with the paper enclosed, and then you remove the paper after. Anyway, so I have 3 fabrics that I've exhausted, and this is one, and there's a couple different styles, talking on the phone, playing records. There's pink, black, and white birds doing all this cute stuff. So I love this fabric. Have 18 of those in this fabric. So And then the next fabric that I found is this one. And this, hold on, sorry. This has like old-fashioned lady names on it. And little flowers. But I am in love with these because, first of all, my grandmother's name is Mary. My mom's name is Jane. My grandma's sister is named Rose. Okay, so that's on there. My grandma's middle name, Virginia. I have a cousin named Sally. I have one of my grandparents' dearest family friends was named Leela, and she babysat my mom all the time, and she was a very special lady. So Leela's on there. My father's mother's name on here, which is Betty. And I think that's it. Unfortunately, my father's mother's name is not on here, even though I feel like it would totally fit because her name's Peggy. Her name was Peggy. Still is. I think of people as eternal. But yeah, so her name totally would have fit in this group, but it just would have been perfect if her name could have been in there as well, but whatever. So yeah, these ones are really special and cute, and I don't know, makes me feel a little sentimental. I'm not a super sentimental person, but like, oh, it's kind of like, oh, made me happy. And then, so there's 18 of that one as well. And then this one's pretty easy to show. I'll just show you the top one. I have 18 of these with cute little bunnies. Some of them have pink bows, some have blue, some have yellow bows. They're very adorable. And the best part is the little face on the back. I mean, you know, it's stupid, but whatever. Makes me happy. So I have quite a few hexies already ready. And I will say that I've attempted to do this before, okay? These little hexagons, paper-pieced hexagons. And I was looking at all the ones that I have, and I have a lot from a previous venture, and I just didn't like any of them. Like, I was kind of just over all the fabric. I didn't feel like they fit together. I don't know. But this time I'm trying to use mostly kind of vintage-y inspired fabrics, and actually most of what I'm using is from a fabric line called Cotton and Steel. These bunnies are not. I got this at Joann. It's in their Easter section right now, but they were so sweet. I couldn't. And I've mentioned, I think before, the association I make with bunnies and my son Warren because of his name being Warren. That's a bunny home. So I do kind of like bunny imagery for him. I also like tiger imagery for him. Because he's Year of the Tiger, and holy crap, is he a tiger. I mean, this kid owns the place. Yeah. Yeah. I'm proud of him. But he's a rascal. So yeah, I have those completed, and I'll go ahead and show other fabrics that I have lined up to make more hexies. So I have this one. Of course, I mean, come on. Who couldn't? And I just got like eighth yards. And I got 18 out of an eighth. With quite a bit of waist, because the way that I arranged them, I wanted to have like the image kind of in the middle. So there will be quite a bit of waist, but not a ton since it's only an eighth, and it doesn't break the bank. This is a Cotton and Steel. Strawberries! Again, Cotton and Steel. I love Cotton and Steel. They have such like a cute mid-century aesthetic to them, which is kind of, other than like flapper era, mid-century. Like, I'm such a huge fan of like vintage Pyrex and stuff like that. So this, again, cotton and steel. This one's super mid-century. Look at that. Love it. And then this one is actually a fat quarter. With the adorable tigers. Again, tigers! Because that makes me think of the boy. Cotton and steel. Again, cotton and steel. And then I got a bigger piece of this because the design is really spread out. And I wanted to get... I wanted each hexagon to have a little raccoon on it. Look how cute! Or some flowers, you know. So this is a bigger, I think this is a quarter yard piece. And last but not least, this really beautiful floral print. This is a Joanne one, but I thought it still fit with the other fabrics that I've got going. So far it's very pink. a lot of pink. Pink and blue. That's fine with me. It can be uber girly. Because, you know, I can be pretty girly sometimes. And, you know, it's my quilt. So. Yes. So I'm very, very, very excited about my hexies. And I hope I will actually stick with it this time. We shall see. So yeah, that is fun. I would recommend getting yourself some of this Thread Heaven if you plan on doing EPP, English Paper Piecing, because this stuff is like a waxy material and you run your thread through it a couple times and it coats your thread. And it doesn't curl up as much and tangle up as much, and it's just a little easier on your hands as well to hand stitch. So, highly recommend. One other fabric that I got that I don't think I'm going to use in the quilt is this. I love bugs. I love bugs. And I just thought it was really beautiful. So this might actually end up being a project bag for me. Look at that bee. Oh my gosh. Oh, love it. That'll probably end up being like a project bag or something. Eventually, you know. You know how it is. Okay, so the rest of the fabric that I'm going to show is actually for projects that I have planned. The first of which is a baby project, and I'll show you what it is. I want to make these bloomers from Wixton. I have not purchased this pattern yet, but I will now that I have fabric, but they're just really, really cute. And of course these are floral in the picture, but there's no reason why I could not make them for a little boy. And I found ridiculously adorable fabric. This is a linen. I think it's linen. It feels like linen. With these cute little Boston Terriers. Holy, holy, holy. I'm in love. I'm in love. My husband does not like flat-faced dogs. I love all dogs. I am an equal opportunity dog lover. But I bought this and I was like, look what I got. I'm going to put our kid in it. And he's like, oh man. So me and Warren actually really want to get like a French bulldog, eventually, you know, in the future someday. we're like, you're outnumbered, dude. We're going to get it. It's going to happen. Look at that sweet face. So these are very cute. These will be very cute. And I want to get a couple other prints and stuff to make some more. I might actually make some out of diaper fabric, which is a kind of laminated on the inside fabric. Laminated makes it sound like it's plasticky, and it is kind of, it's like a waterproof fabric, but on the outside it feels soft and it's still very pliable. I don't know. I was thinking about getting some of that kind of fabric to make some as well as diaper covers. Maybe. Next fabric that I'm going to show is for a project that I actually have made before. This is the washi dress by Made by Ray. Oh, shoot. Yeah, Made by Ray. And there's also a tunic version. I have made this dress before, and I really like the way it fits. I tried it on yesterday. Yes, over the bump, I tried it on. I made the extra small, and it fit like a glove yesterday when I tried it on. So I think I'm going to make it again. I'm going to do the small, because apparently when Jessica gets pregnant, she goes from being a flat A cup to being a C cup, and then after pregnancy and into breastfeeding, I go into like almost a D cup, and then when I'm done with all that, I'm back to being a barrel-chested boy. Flat. So that's more than you ever wanted to know about my breast size fluctuation, but it is relevant because I'm talking about sewing something to fit me. So I am gonna do the next size up, I think. It'll be fine. Because the size that I have currently in my closet is just a little bit snug. Just a little. Like I could wear it if I wanted. I could wear it and I would not be uncomfortable. But just in case, I'm gonna go up. So yeah, I'm gonna make a couple of these, I think, because it's not maternity. But I've seen a lot of people do maternity with this, and of course I tried it on, and I have a huge stomach right now, and I thought it looked cute. So I'm not going to do the dress, though. I'm going to do tops. But yeah. Now, I'm laughing because the fabric that I got to make these is so grown up. It's so mature. I will make some that a grown-up would wear, but for now, I couldn't resist this. Look at that! OMG. Is this not the cutest fabric in the world? So I'm gonna make a top. With this, I'm gonna try to come up with a, like, Peter Pan collar to go with it, to kind of tone down some of the wild print, you know, with a solid colored collar. But oh my gosh, I love it so much. And y'all know I love space and I love aliens, and this is very vintage, like, atomic era, mid-century era, but very, very childish. I love it so much. I love it. And so that's one top. And the second fabric that I got is just as immature. I don't know. Oh, yeah. I'm an adult. Look at this. Cupie dolls. Freaking Cupie dolls. And look at this little dog. Oh, oh my god. I don't know if you guys know, but I think I've mentioned that I'm a doll collector. I have quite a few dolls, and Cupies are among them. I love Cupie dolls. I love the vintage ones, and there are actually newer ones. that are released in blind box form, that are vinyl. And I love those too. Oh my god. I love them so much. And so I saw this before Valentine's Day, and I was like, I have to have that. But the fabric store was closing, and I didn't know how much I needed, and I was kind of in a rush, and I was nervous. And so I went back after Valentine's Day, and I was like, guys, where is the Kewpie fabric? Because if I can't get the Kewpie fabric, I'm gonna die. And I'm still here, so good thing I got the fabric. And again, same thing with this one. I'm gonna do the washi tunic, and I'm gonna try to do a Peter Pan collar on there. I dress like a 5-year-old. I do. It, you know, it's okay. I like me. So embarrassing, but I'm also very excited about it. Nonetheless. Okay, so take a breath, take a breath, take a drink. I have more to talk about. last segment that I'm gonna do here is acquisitions. I have quite a bit of yarn to show, so I'm gonna go ahead and just hop right into that. So first things first, I picked up this ball of opal in this really fun colorway. It's opal, it's sock yarn, it's, I don't know what else to say about it. Here's a picture of how it stripes up. And yeah, I just really like the colors. It kind of made me think of BMO from Adventure Time, but I don't know. Next up, I placed an order from Quince & Co. And this is what I got. So I got 2 skeins of, which one is this? Quince & Co. Osprey. This one is the Heathers in Caspian, I guess? Caspian? And then this one is Gingerbread. And these are worsted weight, 100% wool, non-superwash. And I got these to make soakers for the baby. And I found a couple like cable-y patterns that I thought would look really, really nice in either of these. So that's that. And then these two are Finch from Quince & Co. The blue is Aleutian. And then this one is called Honey. And they're just, these are gonna be used together. This is so soft, and it's not superwash. It's gonna be perfect for soakers. I'm gonna make the Rocky Pants by Tin Can Knits. And I think I'm gonna make 2 pairs. So there's a close-up of the pants. So you see there are 2 colors. So I think I'm gonna make one with this as the main color, and then one with this as the main color, and then use the other for contrast. So I'll get 2 pairs of pants out of this. That is my hope. I do not know, maybe it won't happen. I could always get more yarn, right? But I'm super, super excited about these yarns, and they're so soft. I just want to make myself some clothing out of these. Love it. Love it. And this has kind of been like my color scheme for babies, it seems like. This go round. This, I don't know. Just feels right. Maybe because I live in the Pacific Northwest and Those are very Pacific Northwest colors. I also was fortunate enough to catch an update by Legacy Fiber Arts, Sue of the Legacy Knits podcast. She did a series on Gilmore Girls, and she did the girls first, and then she did the boys. And I got in on the boys, and got these two skeins. So the first one is a cashmere fingering. This is Kirk on cashmere. I will say that on cashmere, and I said this about the Lolo Did It Lucille yarn too, the colors don't get as saturated on cashmere. So I feel like this looks quite a bit lighter than some of the other, than it does on the other bases. But I still love it. It's got like just a cacophony of colors. And I love it. I'm totally fine with it. I am okay with this yarn. This yarn is fine with me. So this is Kirk. And then this one is Logan. It's like a golden yellow, white with blue. This is not cashmere. This is the Steel Toes, which is 7525 superwash merino nylon. But look, oh my gosh, look at it. All these colors, like, I don't know. I love it. Logan is not my favorite, boy of Stars Hollow. I'm a Jess girl, because I'm a Jess, and Jess has got to stick together, okay? Yeah. But I liked this color better than I liked Jess's color, if that makes sense. I like all of them. They were all really beautiful. It was hard to choose, but ultimately these were my favorites, so yay! I got them, and I really, 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 really want to cast on a new pair of socks, but I'm trying to be good. I'm trying. Last yarn that I will show is one that I've seen on so many podcasts, for a good reason. It is the Dogstar Knits Double Dog Dare colorway, which was a collaboration with David of the Dog Dare podcast. And there's his little... I was watching the Dog Dare podcast as he was talking about this, and I got super emotional. Because I get super emotional, usually. I mean, it's just who I am. But David was talking about his pets that he's lost and all. Oh gosh, and I'm pregnant, guys. I got super emotional. And I was like, I'm gonna go buy that yarn. I'm gonna go buy it. So I bought it, and it's beautiful. It has blues in it, and browns. Of course, obviously, charcoal and black, but the depth of color in this is really, really impressive and beautiful. And Dogstar Knits is pretty awesome. Pretty good. Pretty good. I've been watching a lot of Curb Your Enthusiasm. Love it. Go get it if you still can. I haven't checked to see if it's still available. There's another colorway that is more kind of like a creamy, creams and browns, so lighter colors, that part of the proceeds go toward a doggy themed charity, I think for service animals. And I kind of want that one too, but I just really, really, really liked this one. And this is gonna be, I think, a hat for my husband. When I saw it, I was like, ooh, I wanna put my husband in that. So, love it, love it. That is all my yarn that I have to show this week. I do have one more thing, though.
Relevant to our interests.
I was naughty. And I got myself a set of signature needles. And it's not gonna focus. Signature needles. They're new circulars. Yes. So, they only have one size, 2.25 millimeters, which is fine. I really want to cast something on these and try them out, but I'm telling myself that I have to finish a pair of socks that I have on the needles before I go ahead and do this. So hopefully I'll finish those arrow socks like I intend to, and I'll be able to cast something on this week using these. Now, okay, let's talk about these. They're expensive, okay? I have a few sets of signature needles. I have two sets of straight needles, one set of DPNs in a larger size than this, and I also have one set of circular needles by them, which are my favorite circular needles. However, they no longer make them. What they do now with their circular needles, with the exception of these are fixed. They're not interchangeable or convertible. Okay, they're fixed. Now they offer their larger sizes as convertible. So you buy your cord in whatever length you want. You buy your tip in whatever size that you want. And your cord only matches one size. You can't take that same cord and put it on another one, okay? Which, I mean, I guess I can see how some people might find that useful. To me, that's not useful, okay? I don't like interchangeable needles, okay? I don't like them. I feel very insecure with them. I've had too many. I use them all the time. Okay, because I have a set from Knit Picks from ages ago. I use them all the time, but I always have this anxiety with them. And I've heard issues with every brand, every single brand. I've heard a problem. So I don't like them. I prefer to use a fixed circular. I have never used the Signature convertible set, but I'm still nervous about it, and it kind of upsets me that they don't make fixed circulars anymore, because they really are. They really were my favorite. So, that's a rant. I feel like it's a ploy to get more money, and it disgusts me. Capitalism disgusts me, okay? Anyway, I got these. They're fixed, they're beautiful, they are shorter needles, which is nice. And I'm just hoping that in with them coming out with these fixed circular needles, that maybe, just maybe, there's a light at the end of the tunnel for me. And maybe they'll bring back larger sized fixed circular needles, because it's bullshit. Okay, I'm gonna say it. It's bullshit. That convertible stuff, bullshit. I'm not into it. Makes me mad. However, I do love Signature. I love their straight needles. I'm one of those people who will use circular, straight, DPNs. I don't really care. As long as it's a nice needle, I'm fine with it. So, yeah. I'm just like, is there a light at the end of the tunnel for me? I don't know. Even if it just ends up only being these, and, you know, they never bring circulars back and the others. Because I refuse to call those circulars. Those are, I don't even understand the point of those. Okay, so, sorry, rant over. Jessica's fine. Everything's fine. Everything's fine. Jessica's fine. The world's not ending because they stopped making needles that I like. Except that it feels that way. That felt like it might have been a really long episode. I'm not sure because split it into 2 days. So I feel like I've been recording for 2 days straight. And I appreciate everyone suffering through if you've made it this far. You are my people. Just, you know, keep being awesome. Knit some shit. Do some stuff. You know, just keep making.